So it means young generation shouldn't be afraid of AI, robotics, or robot, which will replace them in their job market. Not at all.
They should
create the world for themselves.
They should. That's why I said technology should not be the master. You'll be the master. So technology which is harmful to you, don't ever use the door, because it will be harmful. Always remember, technology can be blessing, technology can be a curse. So don't open the curse door of technology. Technology can destroy the whole world. One little bomb for the whole world is enough. Don't ever go to that technology. It's possible to make that technology, but don't go that path. You design the technology, you are the master of technology. You design the technology for doing good to people, not harm to people.
If young people ask you what's the idea they should be coming up to change the world, where would you reckon for them to keep looking for these new ideas?
Yeah, I've been talking about something. I said, first thing, poverty. So nobody in the world should be a poor person. Poverty doesn't belong to human being. So remove it. It's artificially imposed on human being. Remove that part by bringing technology, ideas, and so on. So I talk about three zeros: zero poverty, zero unemployment, zero net carbon emission. So if you can create a world with three zeros, we have a happy world. We have protected the planet by making it zero carbon emission planet. We have protected the people by creating zero poverty planet, and zero unemployment, not through AI, which will make more unemployment. So we stop that. We don't want that. We want zero unemployment so that every one of us happily engaged in doing things as an entrepreneur, as somebody who is the master of his life. So these are the minimum is three zeros. Then you can add many other things to happen. Yeah.
So you see the future is for entrepreneurs to change
the
world, to drive the world to change.
Absolutely.
Not for people who work in any large organization or
employed. I would put it this way. I would say human beings are not born to work for somebody else. Human beings are independent person. Basic feature of human being, he or she is endowed with unlimited creative capacity. That's what the human being is. You and me are packed with unlimited creative capacity. That's why we are born. It's not something that we added by something. We are born with that package, unlimited creative capacity. So our job is to unleash that, discover that creative capacity, how far we can go. During the lifetime, the more we discover ourselves by our expressing our creative capacity, better life that we have lived. Job is the opposite. Job freezes your creative capacity. Job abandons your creative capacity. Lock it up, because job doesn't need any creative capacity. Job is run by instructions of your boss. Boss tells you do this, you do that. Boss says you don't do this, you don't do that. So that's by instruction. Even if you don't agree, if you don't like, still you have to do it, because that's boss's order. That's a killing of creative capacity. You are no longer an independent person. I said human beings are not born to be driven by instruction for somebody else. Human being is born to unleash their creative capacity. So I said entrepreneurship is a natural to human being. But we created an economy which is job-oriented, sacrificing the creative capacity. I'm trying to withdraw that, saying go back to the creative capacity. Be an entrepreneur. Find out how far you can go. The sky's the limit. You can do anything you want and pursue that path.
In Thailand, not only talking about pursuing the business, but people still having hard time to have access to credit from large bank, from established bank, not to mention how they can live on or to get out of poverty. So what do you think banking sector or large organization in Thailand can help for people who just want to get on with their daily life?
Yeah. Not only in Thailand, globally, entire financial system is designed in the wrong way. It's designed to make rich people richer. That's their job. So if you say, give it to the money to the poor people, say, why should I? I'm designed to help rich people get richer, and I do that. That's why rich people keep rich, becoming richer. As a result, 1% of the entire population of the world, world has about 8 billion people, 1% of the people own 99% of the wealth of the entire world. 1% owning 99%. What kind of system is that? And that is getting worse, meaning less than 1% tomorrow will be owning more than 99%. So what is left for everybody else? 99% of the people in the world has only 1% of the world wealth. So this is not something that we should be proud of. This is crazy. So we have to change that system. So banking system is the vehicle by which it is done. So we need to redesign the banking system. Instead of working for the rich, they should be working for the poor.
Professor, you've driven people with big idea to get rid of poverty, zero carbon emission, and then
zero unemployment.
What else would you like to do more?
Well, there are so many other things to do, like for migration, for example. People move from rural areas to small city, from a small city to a big city, from big city to a big country, always moving out. So people who were born in a place, they don't stay the place where they are born because there's no opportunity. They're always searching for opportunity. So the migration begins, wave after wave and after wave. We can undo that. People can live where they are born because we can create opportunities by social business so that it becomes a productive place. It has its own economy. And there are problems with water. Clean water is not available everywhere. How to bring clean water to everybody. The problem of plastic. Plastic is everywhere and it's killing the whole world because it's coming to our food. In the food, we are now eating plastic. And every month, we are eating plastic about the size of a credit card. We are eating it, but we don't know. It's a microfiber coming from our own clothes, not from something else. And then we have the plastic. Plastic is clogging our canals, clogging our river, and occupying whole ocean of plastic. How to address that? So these are the problems that we have to face. And we can do that. We don't have to get worried and kind of surrender. We don't have to surrender. As I said, we have unlimited creative capacity and nothing is impossible for us. Only thing, we have to make up our mind. If we make up our mind, we'll get it done.